read that fight wrong. Jesus. At least he doesn't move when he's going through that whole little animation there. Oh man, you went down easy too. Hoi! I love it. Excellent. So that's 2 out of 3? I think. Yes, one more sword piece. And I'll have my sword upgrade to level 3. That actually went quite a bit quicker than the first time around. If I remember... Well, mind you, I was sitting on that last sword piece for quite some time this playthrough. So it's not the quickest progression with that. I suppose it's relatively the same, perhaps. Maybe. All right, that went better than I remember. I recall that being quite a slog. Oh man, you just love. Whoa. They always get that first hit in. I always make the mistake of giving them the opportunity to get that first hit in. Oh man, that was the bare minimum range for my swipe. Push that a little bit too close. You know what? I'm gonna try ground pounding on this fool. Oh, no you don't. Oh, you bastard. You got me with your flailing pieces. That's some bullshit, but you took yourself out like a coward. Good for you. I hate that guy. So annoying. Just constantly throwing those exploding little bastards at you. Oh, so... yeah. More and more and more to find and explore. That's one thing that I kind of really appreciate about this game is the level backtracking. It almost feels like it can be done to a minimum. I suppose if you kind of lose which way you're going or your sense of direction's a bit off kilter, that... oh, this is one of the water taps. Oh, yes, I've gotten to it. Ah, I've finally gotten to the aqueduct area. Now, you may wonder, well, Garrett, that doesn't make any sense. There's nothing but a giant open chasm of nothing here. How could this be the aqueduct area? Well, if you've been paying attention long enough, you will know that the environment is always changing. Ever changing. DJ, play me that nuclear silo horn. And while this pops up, I'm going to top up my tea. Ooh, there we go. Oh, yeah, the big fishies. I completely forgot about them. And Hob is never going to get used to that. He's going to be like, man, what is this horrifying shit? Mind you, I imagine I would be taken quite aback if I'd seen what is kind of the equivalent size of a bloody continent just popping up in front of me. Now we take a look at the map, and oh, of course it doesn't show all the new stuff that has been brought into the world, but it's just like, this area has expanded quite significantly. And we're into the water level. Not that it's that horribly hard. This is actually the part. There's a little puzzle just on the other side of all this. You can actually see the block there where the game just broke on me for a bit. And I'm like, okay, I guess I'll just restart the game and come back to it after I restart. Must swim faster. So you got these fishies that are always after you. You gotta lead them away, scare them off with a loud, obnoxious bell. We got these lovely turbines, but one of the turbines cannot be activated just because it is gunked up a little bit too much. So got this one up and running. No problems there. See what you need. See how progression should come. And you look at this one and you're like, oh, that's not going to be good. Let's press the button and see how that reacts with all this gunk on it. Nope. So we need to clean things up around here. Where? I want to head that way, huh? I don't want to be bouncing off things too much and don't want to be spending too much time in the water. Because that is when Big Fishy will come after you. Oh. Get this platform back up here. Come on, hop. Give that thing a nice little tug. Remove the limiters off that. Ride that back up. And now that we have this, might be able to make this jump. Yes! Woohoo! Actually, there is a... Nope, that's a save point. Activate that anyways, just to avoid any unnecessary issues. And then we explore, and punch out that door! What do we find? Oh. It's not even like a big secret, it's actual progression. And that's some of the sneaky stuff that this game does. All the time. I think I've mentioned that countless times, how sneaky this game can be. Where it's just like, oh, you overlooked this tiny little thing here? Well, you're screwed till you find it. Well, I messed up that jump real bad. But, it wasn't that necessary. Some people would say I pulled a boner. Wow, I couldn't even outrun that. I'm just gonna go down here, okay? New dungeon, who dis? There's a nice little battery that I need. And that unlocks that over there, so I'm going to need to come back down there. I'm going to have to take care of this big bastard. He's going to be a big problem. Come on now, turn around. Thank goodness that stuns him for a second. Ow. I think he took off quite a few more, heart little valves than he usually does. Just keep rolling. Ha! Man, those invincibility frames. Shit. Get one couple apples and I'll be able to take a good hit from him. And this will be our last encounter. No, you managed to survive. You fool. Getting too confident. I need more apples. Please, tall grass. Give me one more. Excellent, that's all I needed. Oh, and he pops up like six. Well, as long as I get my upgrade points for that, I'll call that a draw. Or not. Yeah. That popped up. So that works. Ah, another vantage point. I knew there would be something here. Like, they wouldn't open up that gate for absolutely nothing. Hey, little guy. How's it going? Well, I should continue on with my adventure now. So now that I have that battery, plug it into this thing over here, and that will start supplying power and energy. And hopefully, well, allow me to do some... Oh, it'll turn on that button over there. That'll extend the bridge. Or it's just going to change up the whole bloody environment for me. Why not? And didn't even turn on the button. Damn. I thought I could access that switch from there. So that lifted that up, giving me the traversal I needed to get around there. I knew that there would be a blind jump here eventually. Oh, Jesus. Getting a little too fancy funky here. Dropping out sword combos, wombo combos. So now that I'm all the way up here... Oh, another battery. There we go. Come on now. Don't fall. Don't need to be doing that falling there, bye. Go on the other side and just kick it off the ledge because... Really? Oh. Guess I got... Come on now. Kick it off from this side. And boop. Or punch. Kick, punch, whatever. You know, it's Hob. He goes by the beat of his own drum. There. Man, I could just imagine Hob beating on a drum. It would be like a thunderclap every time. Cool. Excellent. And this will bring me... Oh, there we go. Open up this gate. Nice little shortcut. Haven't opened up too many shortcuts lately. I feel a bit depressed about that. I'm so proud in the first, going through the first kind of few little areas, and it's just like, here's a shortcut, here's a shortcut, here's a shortcut. You want this shortcut? Look at that shortcut. What a shortcut, eh? Dick. Man, I'm taking some good hits here. Jeez. You gonna give me an apple? Yes. Yes, they do. Alright, then. Get my health up a tiny bit by killing a few of you little aphids. I guess cutting up some grass and finding some apples amongst that is a good idea, too. Just one more. Make me a happy boy. Thank you. Excellent. Oh, these damn spitters. I hate these things. And I'm going to be flooding this area as well, so I'm going to have to, I think, navigate around them in the wet. Whoa, Jesus, those bugs came in fast. Okay, so this is the one where his armor's powered up and I have to rip it off his back. I think. Yeah, absolutely, that's what has to happen. There we go. So there are certain ones. Oh, it's the dudes with the really big axes that I can't. Alright, I see. Ooh, almost didn't get out of the range of that. Jeez. I think I got him locked on. Oh. Woo-wee! Just gotta keep tumbling and rolling. So those guys are gonna become a lot more common as well. Just because... They gotta get harder and they gotta get tougher. So, have that opened up. That's allowing me to get up this ladder here. And that'll allow me to turn on something with the aqueduct over. I think I need to. Oh, yes, I see exactly what I need to do there. Mike, something. Needs to be changed here. How about if I just do that? Is that a good enough change for you? Yeah, that'll allow me to teleport over to the other side of the platform. Much, 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 much more convenient. Blup, blup, bup, bup. And it didn't pull me through. Come on now. I'm holding X. He's always so gung-ho, so ready to just swing his sword and wipe something out. Now, do I want to take care of this guy? Oh, jeez. Lots of exploding. Lots and lots and lots of exploding. Frightening. Very, very frightening. Galileo. Galileo. And this was the puzzle I keep mentioning, where it's like, yeah, the game broke. And I was super confused. I'm like, what the hell? Come on, guys. I think that was... this is, like, one of the first major bugs I'd run across in the game, where it's just like, I can't progress. And then I just restarted or reset it, and it was totally fine. Ah, block-moving puzzles. Part of video games since... God, I don't even know, but it's been a part of video games for quite some time. Well, give me that nice shine spark. There we go. No, get off the damn block hob. Get off the block hob. And we have life! Power! So now I'm gonna have to get back down there and punch that thing because it's gonna teleport me right there. But using my quick dash makes it quite a bit easier. Oh shit, yeah. One thing that I noticed when, you know, the puzzle was broken and I had completely forgotten. There's always stuff hidden around here. Check the map. Hell, I even missed a stamina upgrade over there. Mind you, it might be behind some corruption. I can't get to it quite yet. But I can always come back to that. Mind you, the 3 bars of stamina is pretty damn convenient, too. I could not imagine needing more than 3 bars of stamina. So, oh, okay. I don't even remember where this is going to take me. But it turns out, yes, I remember this section now. This was one of the creepiest parts of the game. Not that this game is a super action-intense horror genre kind of game, but that giant goddamn fish. Or no, this might not be the one with the giant fish where he's haunting you the whole time. No, this isn't the one. Damn. I was remembering a cooler part, and now I've alluded to something that's not gonna happen for a while. I think I need that platform to jump across something, but I'm going to... Okay, camera's not cooperating. That definitely seems like that would be where a secret is, right? I'm not crazy, am I? Well, a little. Everybody's a little crazy, but there should definitely be a secret in there. I feel it in my bone. Get this door open. What the? Oh, broken ladder. Like, what the hell is that? Or maybe I'm pulling this the wrong way. Either way, do a little bit of run up on the pipes. Pipe run in. Damn it. Fuck. Now, out of the, dungeons I've run across so far, this one's pretty good. It's not the most interesting, you know, it's just a lot of trying to find what you can traverse on. I was about to say, I'm like, I don't even remember if there's too many enemies in this section. Then, you know, enemies galore. Well, one shows up right in time to stop me from saying, I don't remember how many enemies. Seems like my stamina bar resets quite a bit quicker now, too. Yep. Four hits. Yeah, that guy goes down a lot quicker with my upgraded sword. Love it. Now, if I can move this track here, I would think that I should be pulling it this direction. So I'm pretty damn sure I needed to jump across something, but... yeah, right here. Yeah, this is a moment. What else do we got hidden? Actually, so we have 3 upgrades and a stamina gear. Now it's just a matter of finding them. And all the sneaky little crevices of the game. Really? I can't literally jump over that pipe. Is that what you're telling me? Now, this little hole over here is nothing. It looked like it would be something, but that was just my imagination. Oh, oh. I felt my thumb go a little askew on the analog stick when I made that jump. I'm like, no, I've gone way too cockeye on that jump. I'm not going to be making that. Turns out, I made it. Just uncertain at times. What is a makeable jump, and what the game decides is just like, nope, you are too many degrees off of what you want to do right now. We're not going to allow it. Oh, these damn robots. Now the purple goo. Yeah, that doesn't hurt me. But I do have to watch out for these filthy corpuscles. Nope. Just stay out of their range and should be fine. Well, I'm happy that the explosion of that robot didn't actually hurt me. Because for a second there, I'm like, man, I'm standing right on top of that damn robot. I am going to be taking some heavy damage there. But that was not the case. I'm kind of happy about that. Oh, yeah. This puzzle. So I get that on there. And then I move that on there. But then when I move that, it's going to be way off kilter there. So, no, wait. I should start from, okay, the center does move. Shite. Just moves at a much slower rate. Okay, I got the juice there. If I... Well, alright. That looks like it's totally connected. Seems like it was... Wow, they gave you quite a bit of leeway on that. I appreciate it. And since this one was slightly obstructed... Alright, everything looks super happy up there. I'm just going to go over here for a second. Can't press anything on that just yet. Anything hidden here? I'm trying to look at the upper area as the camera is all panned up there, just to see if there's anything of great use. So, I gotta go running through all that filth. This is... So, whom to avoid... Do you guys just get angry, or... Oh, yeah, you're the ones that poisoned me earlier. I remember that now. That thing was a son of a bitch. You are a son of a bitch. Whew. The sliding, the jumping, and bippity-bopping. Nice use of the pipes again. It'd be better if, you know, wasn't getting caught on the environment. Well... Trying to get up the damn manhole? Yes. Oh, Jesus. Wasn't paying attention. I was looking at where I needed to go and not where I was going. So, do I want to... No, I want to head left. Up. That was a hell of a save. I'm like, oh, I'm dead. And I was still holding left while I decided to hit left bumper again, and wow, the range on that. That seems a little extreme, but fuck it, I'll take it. Sure, why not? Oh, that's an actual light up. You know when you get into those moments where you make a bit of a bounce and then you correct and then you overcorrect and then you overcorrect again and then you just fall to your death and die? That is exactly what happened right there. It wasn't great. Oh, no, fuck. I was trying to jump through the hole. I missed it. Okay. This time, but with feeling. Oh, I'm feeling it. Hey, good boy. It's just the little funky things that Hob does where it's like... Well, he will never go up that. Never, ever, ever. Oh, wait, look, he's totally going up that. Sweet. Come on now. Acknowledge that I want to go to you. Okay, let's try to make up this pipe without, you know, all the troubles in the world. Sweet. Isn't it grand? Oh, God. It's that damn fish. I hate that thing. And this is going to open up a bunch of windows, and it's going to be sitting there just staring at me. One of them should have had it with its eye, like, right up against the glass. It's just like, oh, shit, no. This is not what was needed. Ooh, baby. I'm hearing something large, loud, and electric. But I don't know where it's coming from. I think it's from the area just over to the left, but... screw it, security bot. Your two hits mean nothing to me. Or two heart damage. Okay, so I'm going to have to slide that thing down there in, but I need to get down there in a safe fashion because the fall damage will eviscerate me. Well, might as well plug in this thingamajig. I'm kind of happy that they don't do the old trope of, you know, you gotta move some big thing and... enemies are coming to attack you to slow down your progress. They don't really do that. They tried to do that earlier with that one little block thing, but it didn't quite work out. Or block puzzle. So what exactly are you? Are you some sort of gate or battery or... a big-ass fan blade? Yeah, you look like a big-ass fan blade. Cool. Well, that worked out. And now this will bring me... oh, right to the beginning. And it all worked out just like that. Ain't it sweet? That is interesting. You know, I'm not gonna mention it. I think I just realized a minor issue, but I will have to sort that out and deal with that myself later. Ah, so I didn't have to clear out the corruption. I just needed to get in some fan blades to rip that all up. Tear it up real good. Ooh, man. Look at all them guts and viscera. They're all over the place. Ooh! Oh, I did not realize that Mr. Fishy was right there. That was almost my horrible, painful death. Okay, you need to swim faster. Swim faster. Holy shit. That guy almost completely got me. He almost done did dare done got me. Ah, well. Just need to hit another save point. Yeah, that'll work. Nope. Why would you with the gear and all that? Whatever. We'll just go the long way around. Instead of doing fancy stuff, trying to jump off that. Or, no, I guess I kind of have to. Okay. Wait till that passes. Wait till it all passes and it opens up. Okay. That worked out a hell of a lot better. Pull this here. Raise up the water level and then should be able to jump over to the other side without too much hassle. Or swim over to it, of course. Oh, and there's a beautiful ladder waiting for me. Cool. There we go. Hit a good save point right there. Excellent. All right, that seems like that'll be good for today. Thank you very much for watching another Garrett Plays With Himself in Hob, and until next time, take her easy.